नमस्ते, वेलकम बैक टू कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग क्लास सेशन 5, रिकंसिलेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड फाइनेंशियल अकाउंट्स। टुडे आई विल बी सॉल्विंग टू प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन रिकंसिलेशन ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स व्हेन प्रॉफिट एज पर फाइनेंशियल अकाउंट्स इज टेकन एज बेस। इन ऑल माय प्रीवियस सेशंस आई हैव सॉल्वड the reconciliation statement when the cost account profit was taken as base, but today in this class when profit as per financial accounts is taken as base, how do you calculate or how do you prepare reconciliation statement, what are the items to be added and what are the items to be deducted will be discussed in this session. I am Dr. Uma B. Pujar, Assistant Professor of Commerce, Government First Grade College and PG Center, Dharwad. So this is the problem which I am going to solve today or prepare a reconciliation statement. So this is from Karnataka University, Dharwad, 2020, 15 marks problem which was asked in the annual exams, the SEMEND exams. So prepare a statement of reconciliation from the following data. Net profit as per financial accounts 15,000, works overhead under recovered in cost accounts rupees 3,000, administration overheads over recovered in cost accounts rupees 6,000, depreciation charged in financial accounts rupees 10,000, depreciation recovered in cost accounts rupees 14,000, income tax provided in financial accounts rupees 10,000, bank interest credited rupees 30,000, stores adjustment credited in financial accounts rupees 2,000, value of opening stock is given in cost as 52, value of opening stock in financial account is given as 54,000, interest charged in cost accounts but not in financial accounts is rupees 6,000, goodwill written off rupees 1,000, provision for doubtful debts rupees 4,000, value of closing stock in cost accounts 50,000 and value of closing stock in financial accounts given is rupees 47,000. So this is the problem which was asked for 15 marks. And what you have to do is, first of all, you have to identify what are the items to be added and what are the items to be deducted when profit as per financial accounts is taken as base. And there are two bases. One thing, we take net profit as per cost account or loss as per financial account. And one more base is net profit as per financial accounts or loss as per cost accounts. Now in this session, we have taken the thing given in the problem is net profit as per financial accounts. And profit as per cost accounts is not given, that we have to find out now. Let us see what are the things to be added and deducted. So I'll be giving you some hint here. If profit as per financial accounts or loss as per cost account is taken as the base, then items added shall be deducted and the items to be deducted shall be added. That is, the procedure shall be reversed. It will be totally reversed. All these days, what we have done, what are the things we have added, what are the items we have deducted will be reversed. The whole format will be upside down. That is, in the reverse form, the cost profit will come down and the financial profit will go up and the deducted items will go up and the added items will come down. So it will be reversed. Let us see few hints here. Net profit as per financial account, it is 15,000, which we are going to take as a base here in this column. And for this, you can see here, the format is being reversed. So under recover of overheads in cost. So earlier when we take profit as per cost account, we used to take over recovery or over valuation of overheads in cost, we used to add there, but now the format is being reversed. So whatever under recovered, the expenses or the overheads, whichever is under recovered in cost will be added. And also all purely financial charges, losses, expenses will be added. Undervaluation of opening stock will be added. Whatever things we used to deduct there will be added here. So that is the hint here. You can see here to the left side of this slide, works overhead under recovered, we have to add. Administration overhead over recovered in cost. Administration overhead over recovered in cost, we have to deduct it. And next, depreciation charge in financial books and depreciation recovered in cost book, we have to compare here. And then if it is over recovered in cost, we have to deduct in this format. Income tax provided, it is an expenses, we have to add it. And bank interest credited, it is an income, we have to deduct it. Stores adjustment credited, whatever incomes, gains and credited in financial books are to be deducted in this format. It will be reversed. Value of opening stock in cost and value of opening stock in financial accounts, again in cost books, it is under recovered, we have to deduct it. Interest charge in cost accounts but not in financial accounts, we have to deduct it. It is an income. Goodwill written off, it is an expense, you have to deduct it. Provision for doubtful debts, again, it is an expense, you have to add it. Value of closing stock in cost, value of closing stock in financial accounts, value of closing stock is more here, so we have to add it. So you can just compare the earlier format and compare this format, you can see the format is being reversed. So these are the very important point where you may go, you have to keep in mind, you will definitely go wrong while selecting the items to be added and deducted. So be very careful what is the base you are taking. So if it is financial accounts, the things will be different. If you take profit of cost accounts, the things will be different. So please do remember this format, be thorough with this format, and then start doing the problem. So this is the hint I'm giving here. Yes, students, let's solve this problem now. Yes, students, let's prepare reconciliation statement. So according to the problem, net profit as per financial accounts is 15,000, which we are going to take as base. Net profit as per financial account. Financial account amount given is rupees 15,000. So for this we are going to add, as I discussed earlier, I have given you the hints also. The very first point we are going to add here is works overhead under recovered in cost accounts. Works overhead under recovered in cost accounts. What's the amount? Rupees 10,000. Our next point is income tax provided in financial books. Income tax provided is rupees, this is 3,000, this is 3,000 and this is 10,000. Okay, next, undervaluation of opening stock in cost accounts. Undervaluation of opening stock in cost account is rupees 2000. Is rupees 2000. And next point given is overvaluation of closing stock in cost. So we have to compare it. I have told you in the hints, we have to compare it, and the difference amount is to be taken here. Over valuation of closing stock in cost account, that is the difference amount is rupees 3000. And the next point is goodwill written off. What's the amount given here? That is 1000. And the next is provision for doubtful debts. Provision for doubtful debts. Amount given is rupees 4000. So these are few items which we are going to add here, and when we take the total of this, it's come to rupees 23,000. Now we have to add these two, because we are adding this total, that comes to 38,000. So this is the total here, 38,000 total. And for this, we are going to less or deduct. Less, what are the items shown in the hint box? It is, first point is office overhead over recovered in cost. Office or administration overhead over recovered in cost account. That is, the amount given is rupees 6000. And next, depreciation given in financial books and cost books, take out the difference, and the difference amount should be deducted here. Depreciation over recovered in cost accounts. It is 4000. And the next point is stores adjustment credited in financial books. Stores adjustment credited in financial account. It's given as 2000. Take down. And next is bank interest credited. It's 30,000. And the next time, the last point is interest charged in cost accounts only. Interest charged in cost accounts only. Amount is 6000. So just we'll have a look. So all the, whether all the points are covered or not. Okay. When we take the total of this, it comes to 48,000. So let us deduct this 48,000 and 38,000. So it comes to negative answer, that is 10,000. This will be loss as per cost accounts, because it shows negative figure. So it is regarded as loss as per cost accounts. So this is how we prepare reconciliation statement. Hope you all understood this problem. So when we take net profit as per financial account, we may arrive at profit as per cost account or loss as per cost account, because the amount here is, the deduction amount is more here when we compare to this 38,000. So there is a loss figure given here. So we have concluded it as loss as per cost account. So this is how we calculate or we prepare reconciliation statement. Let us solve one more problem. So let us see what is the problem. This is the problem asked in 2018 by Karnataka University Dharwad for 15 marks. The net profit of XYZ Company Limited appeared at ₹58,500 as per financial records for the year ended 31-12-2017. A scrutiny of books of accounts revealed the following facts. Prepare the profit reconciliation statement and arrive at point as per cost account. Works overhead under recovered in cost accounts ₹1,850. Administration overhead over recovered in cost account ₹970. Just don't read the question blankly. You have to identify which are the items to be added and what are the items to be deducted. While reading the question itself, you should be thorough. Which are the items to be added and which are the items to be deducted? You have to mark it and then go for preparing reconciliation statement. They have given the third point, they have given depreciation charged in financial books and also cost books. Let us see, let us compare it and whether it will be added or deducted, we'll check it. Interest on investment credited, 4,500. Loss due to obsolescence debited in financial accounts, 3,150. Income tax provided in financial accounts, 22,000. Stores adjustment credited in financial accounts, 425. Bank interest credited in financial accounts, 320. Value of opening stock is given in cost book and also financial books. Let us check it out. Value of closing stock is also given in both the books. Let's see what will happen. Goodwill written off is ₹10,000. So loss on sale of furniture is given, preliminary expenses written off, and also interest on bank overdraft debited only in financial books, that is ₹800. Let's check out what are the items to be added and what are the items to be deducted. So when we take profit as per financial account as base, I have, as I told you earlier, few items are to be added and a few items are to be deducted. The format will be in reverse form. So works overhead under recovered in cost accounts, it will be added, and administrative overhead over recovered in cost, it will be deducted. Depreciation charge in financial account and depreciation recovered in cost accounts, it is more in cost account. So over recovered in cost account, it will be deducted. Interest on investment credited, it is an income, deducted. Loss due to obsolescence loss, it is a loss, then add it. Income tax, stores adjustment credit, income tax, it is an expense, again you have to add it. Stores adjustment credited, it is an income, less it. Bank interest credited, it is an income, again deduct it. Value of opening stock in cost and value of opening stock in financial account, it's given here, it is under recovered in cost, we have to added, the difference amount will be added. Value of closing stock in cost account is 22,000. Value of closing stock in financial books is 23,000. So in cost book, it is undervalued, we have to less it. Goodwill written off, it is an expense, add it. Loss on sale of furniture, it is an expense, again add it. Preliminary expenses, it is an expense, add it. Interest on bank overdraft debited. Debited means again it is outflow of cash, so you have to add it. So this is the hint given in this problem. So you have just keep in mind this. It is very important before going to solving or preparing reconciliation statement, we have to identify in this way what are the items to be added and deducted. So let us solve this problem. Okay, students, let us solve this problem now. Again, let us take profit as per financial account as base. Profit as per financial accounts. What's given in the problem? 58,500. For this, we are going to add under recovery of works overhead. Under recovery of works overhead in cost accounts, that is 1850. And the next item is loss due to obsolescence that is 3150. And the next item is income tax provided. Tax provided. Amount given is 22,000. And the next point is goodwill written off. Goodwill written off amount is rupees 10,000. And the next one is loss on sale of furniture. Loss on sale of furniture. Amount given is 1,300. So when we take profit as per financial account as base, all losses, all expenses, all charges will be added. The next point is preliminary expenses. What's the amount given in the problem? Preliminary expenses, 5,000. And the next one is interest on overdraft. It is an expenses. It is an expense. So we have to add here interest and bank overdraft. What's the amount? It's 800. And the next point is undervaluation of opening stock in cost books. Amount is 2,700. So when we add all these together, it comes to rupees 46,800. When we add this together, 58,500 plus 46,800, it comes to 1,05,300 rupees. Okay, for this we have to deduct few items as shown in the hint box. First point is over recovery of administration overhead. Recovery of office or administration overhead. Amount given is 970. And depreciation overcharged in cost. Depreciation overcharged in cost accounts. That's amount given is 700. And the next point is interest on investment. interest on investment. What's the amount given here? 4,500. 4,500. Okay. Next, we'll just mark the line here. We need some more lines here. We'll draw the line. Just a minute. I'll just take 2 more minutes to draw this line. So immediately after drawing this line, I will continue the problem. So this is the line here and one more line here. Okay, this is it. So now let's continue the problem. So interest on investment given was rupees 4,500 and next stores adjustment credited. Stores adjustment credited. What's the amount given? Stores adjustment credited 425. And the next one is bank interest received or credited. Bank interest, all incomes and gains are to be deducted here when we take financial profits as base. And next, undervaluation of closing stock in cost books, that is 1,230. When we add all these together, hope all the points are covered here, all the items are being included. So when we add all these together, it comes to 8,145. So let's deduct this item from 105,300. It comes to 97,155. So this is, what is this? Profit as per cost accounts. So this is how we prepare. We have taken financial profit as base here. When we take financial profit as base, finance cost profit will be the answer. When you take cost profit as base, financial profit will be the answer. So this is how we prepare reconciliation statement. Hope you all understood this problem. I'll be back with some more problem in my next session. Until then, have a nice time and have a nice day. Thank you very much.